Hello, Herman here with a new video in the ClearPass Workshop series where we built the ClearPass deployment from scratch and integrate with Wired, Wireless, Active Directory and much more. In the previous video, we created a guest self-registration workflow based on Aruba Instant and ClearPass. And during that configuration, we found that in ClearPass there is a setting for controller initiated versus server initiated. And in this video, I'll cover the differences and what it exactly is. So first to show you the settings, so it was under the NAS settings, there you have the login method, and we took the controller initiated, which is the best choice for Aruba Instant and Aruba controller wireless. The other option is server initiated, and we will use that for the wired guest in the next video. For that reason, I think it's important for you to understand the differences. So in the video, I'll go through the controller initiated workflow and the differences for the server initiated one. First, the controller initiated guest workflow. Guests get on the network, then the instant AP will have an initial role, which in our case is the guest CP that has a captive portal redirect, and it will redirect that client to the page on the ClearPass. So in the previous video, we went to a self-registration page. So let me show you that from the client. So I have a normal browser here. So normally you will get a pop-up browser, but you can't see what's happening there. But in this browser, what I can do under the tools, enable the web developer tools. And then if I have the network setting under the settings persistent logs, then we can see exactly which URLs are requested by the browser. If we then go to an HTTP site like the Aruba network site, you can see that we actually have that redirect. If we then scroll up in the list of access requests, then the first request we see that's going to the Aruba network, so the actual URL and to the actual IP address of the site. The captive portal redirect will then intercept that connection and take that request and do a redirect based on it. So if we click on it, we can see that we have a GET for the Aruba website. But we see there is a 302 status, which is a redirect. In our case, that's a captive portal redirect. Then in the response headers, what we can see there is a location header. And the location header is telling the client where it needs to go. And you can see the start is the URL on the ClearPass guest page. And that's what we added in our captive portal definition. Then in addition, you can see a lot of information like the client IP, the AP name, all that kind of stuff. And that's also what we can see later on in the ClearPass and what we can use for our access decisions. After the redirect, you can see the actual page is downloaded with all the objects. Then the next step is that we can do the self-registration, and that all runs to the ClearPass guest part between the client directly. So let's register myself. You can see I now have a guest account created and we have the login button there. So before I press the login button, let me go back to the workflow. On the login button, the guest access, it will trigger a controller-based logon. And what that will do, it will tell the client to reach out to the controller based on the certificate that we uploaded to the controller. It's going to the captive portal certificate name, and it's posting the guest credentials to the controller. So let's click that button. And now you can see we are logged in. And to see what happened, let me scroll back to where we were. So there we have our receipt page. Then after we press the logon button, we can see there is a post request. And that post request is going to the name of the certificate in the instant AP. Client will do a DNS request. You don't see the DNS request, but you can see the IP address that was returned. And that's the built-in IP address of the instant AP. And just to be clear, there's no need to create a DNS entry because the AP will automatically intercept the DNS request for this name and respond with its own IP address. The instant AP will always have a built-in IP address, which is also used for a guest network. You can run that in the instant AP, but it's also used for the captive portal. So that AP, it's an IP address of the instant AP. And if we have a closer look in the request, you can see that it's a post request going to the name of the certificate /cgi/bin/login. And then if we have a look in the request, we can see there's form data with the username and the password, as well the redirect URL. And we can see two additional ones, so the CMD and the login fields that are also sent for internal use. So So once the instant AP receives that, it will send in the backend a radius access request to the ClearPass policy manager. And let's have a look in the policy manager. So that's this specific request. You can see all the information like the SSID, the AP name, AP group. We can see in the output, most important there is the Aruba user role. So the other things are for the MAC caching and internal housekeeping. But this is the most important one, that we have the Aruba user role, which is then returned through the access accept. And at that point, the instant AP will change the connection to the guest role, and it will trigger a redirect to the original page. That's happening here. So if we check the response, if we see the raw HTML, you can see there's a meta redirect going to the URL that we had for the override. And if we didn't have any overrides, the original page, initially we went to arubanetworks.com, then that's the page that should be shown there. And after that, the redirect will trigger direct internet access. And because we have switched to the guest role at that point, that is also allowed. Important here is that we have that certificate on the instant AP, and that's required because we post the credentials to there, so the username and the password, and we want to have that secure. That's all good, and this is the controller initiated guest flow. So in the opposite, we have the server initiated guest workflow. The start of that is exactly the same, so we still have that redirect. Client is redirected to the registration page, we'll go through the self-registration page, and at some point we'll press the login. And at that point, that is where it will differ. So there will be two responses at that point. First is there is an HTML response, which does a countdown on the page. And after that countdown, it will do a redirect to the original page. And in parallel to that, there is a COA port bounce running from the ClearPass to the switch. The switch will respond to that. It will shut down the port. It will wait for a few seconds, and then it will bring up the port again. And then normal procedure would be for a new client on a new port that the switch will send out a MAC authentication request to the ClearPass. And then with MAC caching, it will respond to that request. So you see the access accept based on the MAC address and the guest role, and the switch will at that point apply the guest role for that user. In parallel, we had that trigger, so that countdown, and the countdown, if it's on zero, it will trigger and redirect to the original page. And at this point, the access is allowed through the guest access. So this is a slightly different approach, where in the controller initiated guest flow, we see that the client is sending the credentials, and then the credentials are checked in the ClearPass policy manager. We see that in the server initiated workflow, it's the ClearPass server that's sending a COA. After the COA, the port is back, then there is a MAC authentication, and that's basically handled just like we do MAC caching, as explained in the previous videos. At that point, it will come up again and we'll have access as well. So when should you use controller initiated? When should you use server initiated? The difference is that in the controller initiated, the client will post the credentials, and in the server initiated, the ClearPass will trigger a COA port bounce. In the controller initiated, you will need a certificate on the instant AP. However, it will give the fastest and best end user experience there is, and so that's why it's also strongly recommended for all equipment that supports it. That is the APs or the controllers by Aruba. On the server initiated, that's using the port bounce, and that can take multiple seconds, so the end user experience is slightly lower, and you should only use it for equipment that doesn't support the controller initiated. And the server initiated, that's what we will need for the wired switches, and that's exactly the topic for the next video, where we'll replicate the self-registration guest scenario, but then instead on the wireless we'll do that on the AOS-CX wired switches. Looking forward to that video. Hope you like this video as well. If so, please press the like button. And if you have any questions, you can put them either under the video as comments or go to the Airheads community. Thanks a lot for watching.